Good morning and welcome to St. Michael's. At this time, we ask that you silence all cell phones and pagers. Our opening song is number 426, Blessed Be the Lord. Number 426, please rise.
And the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning. You might have noticed at the start of Mass today, instead of using the processional cross, we used our St. Michael's banner. That is because this Thursday, the 29th of September, is the Feast of the Archangels, of Michael, Gabriel, and Raphael. So we honor our patron saint, and at the end of Mass, we will together say the St. Michael's prayer. As we now prepare ourselves for this liturgy today, our Lord challenges us, in fact, our readings challenge us, to not ignore nor neglect the poor who live around us. And so now we pause and call to mind the times that we may have neglected or forgotten the poor. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And let us be seated now to hear God's word.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Thus says the Lord, the God of hosts, woe to the complacent in Zion, lying upon beds of ivory, stretch comfortably on their couches. They eat lambs taken from the flock and calves from the stall, improvising to the music of the harp. Like David, they devise their own accompaniment. They drink wine from bowls and anoint themselves with the best oils. Yet they are not made ill by the collapse of Joseph. Therefore, now they shall be the first to go into exile, and their wanton revelry shall be done away with. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to Timothy. But you, man of God, pursue righteousness, devotion, faith, love, patience, and gentleness. Compete well for the faith. Lay hold of eternal life to which you were called when you made the noble confession in the presence of many witnesses. I charge before God, who gives life to all things, and before Christ Jesus, who gave testimony under Pontius Pilate for the noble confession, to keep the commandment without stain or reproach until the appearance of our Lord Jesus Christ, that the blessed and only ruler will make manifest at the proper time. The King of kings and Lord of lords, who alone has immortality, who dwells in unapproachable light, and whom no human being has seen or can see. To him be honor and eternal power. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, "There was a rich man who dressed in purple garments and fine linen and dined sumptuously each day. And lying at his door was a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who would gladly have eaten his fill of the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. Dogs even used to come and lick his sores. When the poor man died, he was carried away by angels to the bosom of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. And from the nether world where he was in torment, he raised his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. And he cried out, 'Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am suffering torment in these flames.' Abraham replied, 'My child, remember that you received what was good during your lifetime, while Lazarus likewise received what was bad. But now he is comforted here, whereas you are tormented. Moreover, between us and you, a great chasm is established to prevent anyone from crossing who might wish to go from our side to yours or from your side to ours.' He said, 'Then I beg you, Father, send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, so that they may warn them, lest they too come to this place of torment.' But Abraham replied, 'They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.' He said, 'Oh no, Father Abraham, but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent.' Then Abraham said, 'If they will not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded if someone should rise from the dead.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There was a rich man who dined sumptuously each day, and lying at his door was a poor man named Lazarus. Today's gospel story can be a really tough one to hear, for it paints a picture that most of us would rather not consider. As you know in the story, the rich man winds up in eternal torment, while the poor, suffering, hungry Lazarus spends eternity in the bosom of Abraham. What makes this particularly disturbing is the fact that the rich man is not depicted as doing anything harmful or cruel or evil. It is not that he kicked Lazarus each time he passed him. It is not that he yelled obscenities at him whenever he saw him. He basically is just living his life and minding his own business. A good life for sure, a life of privilege and comfort, while Lazarus sits outside by himself with no one to care for him. And the sacred text doesn't show the rich man saying any unkind word or doing any hurtful thing or mocking Lazarus or anything like that. He actually doesn't say a word about the guy. So it's not a stretch to say that the only thing the rich man is probably guilty of is not noticing the man, not paying attention, maybe not even realizing the suffering of a man just outside his door. I guess you could say that to the rich man, Lazarus was invisible. The sin for which the rich man suffers is simply that he paid no attention to Lazarus. The sin for which the rich man suffers is simply that he ignored Lazarus. It is not a sin of commission, doing something he should not do. It is a sin of omission, not doing something he should have done. The sin for which the rich man suffers is the sin of not lifting a finger to help someone that he could have helped with very little effort on his part. So often we think of serious sin as simply being those things particularly vicious or harmful or selfish in nature. You know, the big stuff, for lack of a better term, such as physical or sexual or verbal abuse, theft, robbery, infidelity, racial or ethnic hatred. Many of us convince ourselves that if we just avoid these blatantly sinful things, we are in good shape. God is pleased with us, and we have little to worry about or little to work on. Today's gospel story from Luke seems to be telling us exactly the opposite. The rich man seems to be doing something many of us probably do more often than we would like to admit, and he pays the ultimate price. You may be thinking to yourself, I don't have any suffering guys sitting outside my door every day. What's he talking about? I think those are very same thoughts that I have from time to time. But that's just it. Today we are asked to recognize and acknowledge and have compassion for those we currently are not even noticing. People in our little own worlds who are completely invisible to us. Not because we want to be, but because we simply aren't looking properly, aren't paying attention, aren't really that concerned with the needs of many people other than our little own self. I know there probably are many Lazaruses among our family, among our friends, among our co-workers, and among our fellow parishioners. And I know that some of them we simply walk past, ignore, disregard, and might not even be aware of. They are invisible to us because we choose to not see as God sees. And if we believe the gospel message we just heard, then this sort of neglect, this sort of indifference, and this sort of blindness is much more sinful than we might imagine. And that when we simply fail to notice and respond to the needs of those in our midst, those right in front of us, we might be disappointing God in ways we can't even imagine. And so if we want to be faithful, if we want to please God, if we want to live lives in imitation of Jesus, then we must open our eyes, pay attention to the invisible people right in our midst, the ones who are hurting dearly and for whom no one seems to care. You might ask the question, well, who are these people? Maybe it's the widowed neighbor who is terribly lonely. Maybe it's a coworker who feels he or she doesn't really fit in. Maybe it's a spouse who needs nothing more than to feel desired, respected, and appreciated. Maybe it's a child who feels his or her parents play favorites. Maybe it's an elderly parent who is placed in a home and is rarely visited. Maybe it's a classmate who feels rejected, picked on by everyone. Maybe it's a friend who's going through a divorce and needs someone to lend a compassionate, non-judgmental ear. Or maybe it's a whole group of people, any minority or marginalized group that struggles simply to be treated with the same respect and have the same opportunities as people of the majority. Yes, this is the message the church sets before us in today's gospel. This is the challenge Jesus sets before us in today's liturgy. It's the challenge to take to heart the point of Jesus' parable about Lazarus. It's the challenge to begin loving one another as Jesus loves us. Today, as we carried the banner forth, reminds us of St. Michael the Archangel, who we continue to ask protection from the wickedness and snares of the devil. But we too are called to protect those vulnerable around us. Yes, Lazarus is in our midst today, crying out for help, just as he did in Jesus' parable. The question we ask today, who are our Lazaruses? Who are invisible to us? And the most important question, what are each of us going to do about it?
Let us stand and offer our prayers and needs. Our God has a soft spot for those in need, whatever form it may take. The need for love or life, of dignity or safety. God's word today spoke to us of this divine concern. The scriptures we have heard now guide the prayers that we offer back to our Lord.
In the gospel, the rich man and probably many others ignored and neglected Lazarus. Lord, help us to pay more attention to the needs of those around us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the second reading, St. Paul pushes us to remain on course, keep the faith, and pursue love, patience, and gentleness. In this time when our Christian values are often under attack, help us to stand firm in our beliefs and the teachings of the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This weekend is a special collection for seminarians. We pray for the 23 seminarians in the Des Moines Diocese. May the Lord bless them as they continue their education, and may we support them through their discernment process. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all our young people, that they will listen to the guidance of the Holy Spirit as they make their career choices. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The Knights of Columbus will be conducting their annual Tootsie Roll Drive this weekend and next weekend to help those with intellectual disabilities. As with Lazarus, help us not to neglect anyone in need. Help all those who work with the disabled. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died, especially Maxine Thielen, Rosemary Reining, and Gussie Maloney, the special intentions of this Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the petitions in our prayer basket, for the sick listed in our bulletin, for our family members serving in the military, and for our own personal petitions that we now express in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Together we pray the prayer for vocations found on the back of our missalettes. Oh Jesus, good and gentle shepherd, grant that the men and women from our community may have the grace and the courage to hear and answer your call to priesthood and religious life. Give them the wisdom to realize that life is a gift. Let them realize their life is part of your plan. Call forth those you have chosen to spread the gospel message and help them to freely respond to a life of service in the church. May the parents and families of our parish support and encourage our young men and women to search for, follow, and answer the call of God in their lives. Amen. Let us be seated now for the preparation of gifts. Just a reminder, if you are making a donation to the Samaritan collection, to drop those envelopes in the regular collection. We'll sort those out later today. So thank you for your support to the Samaritan Fund.
Our offertory hymn is number 378, Here I Am, Lord, number 378.
I'm the Lord of sea.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessings may be laid open before us. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy.
Hosanna in the highest.
blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Richard, our Bishop, and all the bishops of the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through you, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace with you. Leonard, peace with you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 328, this bread that we share, number 328. We
Our announcements. This weekend and again next weekend, the Knights of Columbus will be conducting their annual Tootsie Roll Drive for those who are intellectually disabled. Please be generous. The money donated will be given to Concern Incorporated here in Harlan and to the Iowa Special Olympics. As our Jubilee Year of Mercy winds down and comes to a conclusion at the end of November, we are holding a special morning of prayer, reflection, and discussion that will take place in 3 weeks' time on Saturday, October 15, in the Rosamond Perry Center. It will begin at 9 o'clock and end about 11:30 that morning with Father Wayne Goebbels leading the discussion and the session. All are invited to be in attendance. The Pastoral Council has been discussing and considering the possibility of changing the Mass time for this late Mass, moving it up from 11 o'clock to 10:30. If you have an opinion about this time change, let me know or let one of the parish council members know. Our next parish council meeting will be on Tuesday, October 11th. And be sure to check the bulletin insert for the latest issue of the St. Michael Defender and catch up on all of the faith formation news. Thank you to all of our catechists and all who volunteered to help with our faith formation program this year. Let us stand and pray. In honor of our patron saint, St. Michael, it seems fitting and appropriate to me that together we pray the St. Michael prayer that can be found on the back of our messalettes in the upper left-hand corner. And so together we pray. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and the other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Our celebration has ended. Let us go in peace and love to live the gospel.
Thanks be to God.
Our sending song is number 584, Companions on the Journey, number 584.
We are companions on the journey, breaking bread and sharing wine, and in the love we bear is the hope we share. The word of the Lord.